So, hello students, welcome back to the next session of relative velocity method, wherein we will be discussing a problem in which slider crank mechanism is given and we have to find out the velocity and acceleration of the given mechanism in terms of links. Okay, so let us read out the problem first. The crank of a slider crank mechanism rotates clockwise at a constant speed of 300 rpm. So speed is given as 300 rpm. So the crank is 150 millimeter and the connecting rod is 600 millimeter long. So now determine linear velocity and acceleration of the midpoint of the connecting rod. Here, unlike the previous problem, okay, not only we have to find the velocity and acceleration, okay, of the mechanism, we have to find out the velocity and acceleration of a given point on a link. This is very important part of this module. That is an important problem. Okay, so we have to determine velocity and acceleration of a given point on the link. Okay, so second one, we need to find out the angular velocity and acceleration of the connecting rod at a crank angle of 45 degree from inner dead center position. So let us take down the given data. So we know OB is 150 millimeter, AB is 600 millimeter. At the end of AB, there is a slider. Okay, due to the rotation of the crank, the slider moves, correct? So this is what the logic is. Now, speed is also given. That is, the speed of the rotation of the crank is given as 300 RPM. So using that, we can calculate the angular velocity omega. So omega, as we know, is equal to 2 pi n by 60. So that is equal to, when you input the data of 300 in place of n, so you will find the value of omega of the crank as 31.42 radians per second. So when you get omega, or when you get the angular velocity, you can easily find out the linear velocity also. So that is, VBO is equal to omega into the link length r. So omega is 31.42, link length is 0.150 meters. So when you calculate it, you will get a value of 4.73 meter per second. Okay, now we need to find the midpoint of the connecting rod, that is D. Let us consider it as D. Okay, we need to find out the velocity of that point and acceleration of that point. Similarly, we have to find out angular velocity of the link AB and angular acceleration also for that particular link AB. Okay, so very first thing we need to do is we need to draw the configuration diagram. As the people already know, we need to draw the configuration diagram, correct? So configuration diagram can be drawn using your own, that is given values. You can draw a configuration diagram. You can convert that given dimension into any scale of your choice. So no issues, because finally, there is no use of, or whatever the scale you take, we are not going to use those values for the construction of velocity or acceleration diagram, but you have to draw the configuration diagram very neatly, okay, according to the given dimensions. So take any scale you want. Okay, so draw the configuration diagram. So this is what a configuration diagram is. That is exactly to the given scale. Okay, reduce it, increase it. That depends on the available space for the drawing. Okay, so this is the configuration diagram, wherein you can see OB is the crank, which is rotating with a speed of 300 RPM. AB is the connecting rod, which connects the crank with the slider. So slider, due to the rotation of this crank, the slider will move horizontally. Okay, so now let us draw the velocity diagram for the given mechanism. Okay. So in order to draw the velocity diagram, we require at least one velocity. So we have found out the velocity of crank, that is VBO, that is equal to 4.73 meter per second, correct? Now, let me just mark a midpoint on the connecting rod and notate it as D, capital D. Now we will find out the velocity and acceleration of that particular point, D also. Okay, so now when you consider OB, the value of velocity, magnitude of the velocity is known for this particular thing. So consider OB, draw a perpendicular line okay, exactly perpendicular line to the crank OB, because as you know, the velocity vector acts perpendicular to that particular link. Okay, so now what we have to do, we have to draw the velocity vector for the link AB also. So that acts perpendicular to that particular link. So either in upper way or in the downward direction, that we need to check in the velocity diagram. Okay, so now when I consider a slider, it has got only horizontal motion. So there will be no rotation of the slider. Therefore, only horizontal motion is there. Either it will move forward or backward horizontally. Okay, so this is the analysis which you have done. Now take the scale as, see, so the found out value for velocity of B with respect to O is 4.53. So let us take 1 centimeter is equal to 1 meter per second. So that makes the value as 4.5 centimeters. Okay. Now mark the fixed point O. Mark the fixed point O. Consider link OB and draw a line for 4.3 centimeters, 4.6 equal to 4.6 from O, exactly parallel to the line drawn, okay, or perpendicular to the link OB. So let it be OB, and this denotes the velocity of B with respect to O, the velocity of B with respect to O. Now consider the second link, that is AB. Okay, the velocity vector acts perpendicular to it. As we have already drawn, it acts perpendicular to it. So consider that line and draw a parallel line to that, or draw a perpendicular line to the link AB. So we don't know the magnitude of it, correct? We don't know the magnitude. So draw it downwards, because if you draw it upwards, there is no sense at all. Because from O, you have to draw a horizontal line as the slider slides horizontally. So this is the line I'm talking about. So the slider slides horizontally, and it is represented by V AO, or VA, let us say VA. Okay, so this is what, now we have obtained the velocity diagram. Now we have to find out the point D, velocity of point D also. So keep the scale on the velocity of B with respect to A, the line velocity of B with respect to A, and mark the center point. So it is 3.3 or 3.4 maybe. So okay, so that is 1.65, or that will be equal to 1.7. okay, you can just point it out, or you can just mark the point as D, or else you can use the principle of symmetrical triangles and find out the value like this. Okay, see, that is BD by BA. Okay, BD by BA, the original, the BD by BA is equal to BD by BA. See, this BD by BA, sorry, this is not C, this is A. Okay, BD, this length BD, measure it and write it as it is. Do not convert it into meter or anything. So write it as it is. So BD by, remember this, don't convert it into meter. So write it as it is. So BD, measure this distance, then measure this distance also, B to A. So it is equal to BD by BA, that is BD as given in the problem, the original dimension, BA as given in the problem, the original dimension, okay, in meters. So this is BD divided by 3.4, that is when you measure this BA, so it is 3.4 equal to 3.4. So that is equal to 0.3 by 0.6, and it will be equal to 1.7, almost 1.7. So you can mark like this, or you can just measure here. Okay, take a scale, measure the total distance and divide it by 2 and mark the point D. So if it is a center point, okay, then, or it is a midpoint, then it is easy. If the point is given somewhere here, let us say somewhere here, okay, you cannot locate that using this particular way. So you have to go for the principle of similar triangles. Okay, so this was discussed in the theory class also. Now, so once you have pointed out the midpoint, or pointed out the point D, so next step is join O to D. Join O to D so that it will become OD, or the velocity of D is found here. So measure that it will come around 4.1 centimeter, and or that will be directly equal to 4.1 meter per second, because 1 centimeter is equal to 1 meter per second, correct? So that will be equal to 4.1 meter per second. Similarly, measure VA and also VBA. Measure VA also VBA. So that will be equal to 3.4, or directly you can write it as 3.4 meter per second. So similarly, you can find out omega AB. Okay, that is angular velocity. So VAB divided by AB. This is the relation. Do not forget it. It is very important. That is equal to 3.4 divided by 0.6, the given dimension of the link. So that will be equal to 5.7 radians per second. Now the next step is drawing the acceleration diagram. Again, as discussed in the last question, okay, acceleration, when you consider it for any length, have two components, radial or centripetal or normal component, and the other one is tangential component. So let us consider the crank OB. So for this OB, again, we have two components of acceleration, AR of BO, or radial components of radial component of acceleration of BO, and tangential acceleration. So radial component of acceleration is given in terms of V square by the link length, that is V square BO by the link length BO. So we know velocity of the crank. So that is 4.713. So square it and divide it by 0.15. You'll get the value as 148.1 meter per second square. 148.1 meter per second square. Okay, next, AT of BC, or sorry, AT of BO. So is zero, because the alpha is zero, it is zero. So therefore, there is no tangential acceleration for this link or crank. So therefore, the radial component itself is the final resultant component of, or final resultant acceleration of the link. So again, let us consider the second link, that is AB. Again, you have two components of acceleration, AR of AB and AT of AB. So AR of AB can be found out by using the formula V square BA divided by AB, that is equal to 3.4 whole square divided 3.4 square divided by 0.6. 0.6 is the link length, that is AB given in the problem. So when you calculate it, it will be 19.3 meter per second square. Now we need to calculate AT of AB using the acceleration diagram, which will be drawn next. Okay, and the formula to calculate that is known to you, alpha into r, correct? So when you, okay, one more thing I have not written here, that is not shown here, that is the acceleration of slider. Slider does not have two components. Okay, it will only slide in the horizontal direction. So therefore, directly what you can do, you can draw a horizontal line from the fixed points. So that I will show in the acceleration diagram. So now let us take the scale as, say this is the highest value, 148.1 meter per second square. So what I'll do, I'll consider 10 meter per second square is equal to 1 centimeter. So that this will become 14.81 centimeter, and this will become almost 1.93 centimeter. That is almost equal to 2 centimeters. Now mark point O dash, which is the fixed point. Okay, now consider the crank, and the radial component of acceleration acts parallel to this particular crank, correct? Parallel to this particular crank. So what I'll do, I'll take the scale, or I'll say take the scale square. Okay, here the scale is fixed, therefore I can use it very easily. But in your case, when you move the scale, okay, the orientation will change. So that is why use a set square. I know you people know how to use the set square. So draw a line of 14.8 centimeters and represent AR of BO. Now consider second link. So second link, that is AB. So when you consider this link, the radial component acts parallel to the link. And we know the 1.93 is the value for that radial component of acceleration. So draw that 1.9, okay, centimeters, and represent it as radial component of acceleration for BA, link BA. Now the tangential component acts perpendicular to it, correct? So draw a perpendicular line to that, exactly perpendicular line to that, with unknown magnitude. We don't know the magnitude for this, correct? We don't know the magnitude for this. So therefore, draw a line perpendicular to this line, exactly perpendicular to this line, for unknown magnitude. Let both the components be represented using dotted lines only. When you join both of them, okay, you will get a thick line or continuous line. Okay, so now represent this as AT of BA. Okay, now once you have found out this, now the third link is the slider. So consider slider, it moves only horizontally. So draw a line, horizontal line from O dash, and represent the acceleration of the slider. Represent the acceleration of the slider. So that is A dash and this is B dash. So this is the acceleration of the slider. So you can write AO, or we can write directly AA. Now we have A dash and B dash. Connect those two points and you will get the resultant acceleration for the link BA. Resultant acceleration for the link BA. Okay, join both of them. And get the resultant acceleration for the link BA. Okay, and the sense or the direction I have told you, AT plus AR is equal to A. So therefore, both of them are moving in the same direction, having same direction. Therefore, the acceleration or the resultant acceleration will be opposite to that. Now, on this line, we need to locate point D. We need to locate point D. So measure it completely, locate the midpoint. Locate the midpoint. As you can see here, it is A dash B dash is equal to 10.3 centimeters, what I'm getting here. So therefore, D dash will be equal to 10.3 divided by 2. 2 5s are, 2 1s are almost 5.1 or 5.2, 5.15 or 5.2. Okay, so measure that using the scale and mark point D dash. Mark the point D dash and join O dash to D dash here. Join O dash to D dash here, and this will give you the acceleration of point D dash. This will give you the acceleration of point D dash. Okay, or point D. Fine. So this completes the acceleration diagram. So after this, we need to find out the alpha values and the acceleration for the point D. So we will directly measure it. So AD is equal to 11.5 centimeters. Into 10, that is, we have taken the scale as 10 meter per second square is equal to 1 centimeter. So AD will be equal to 117 meter per second square. Now measure AT of BA. So this is AT of BA. Measure that. In order to find out the alpha, you can use directly this one and you can measure it. So AT of BA or AB is equal to 10.3 centimeters into 10. That is equal to 103 meter per second square. 103 meter per second square. Okay. Now, alpha can be calculated using the formula. Alpha AB is equal to AT of AB divided by AB. That is the link length. Okay. AT of AB, you know, 103 divided by link length is, for AB it is 0.6. So, divide it. And you get the values of alpha, that is angular acceleration, as 171.6 radians per second square. 171.6 radians per second square. So this is how we need to solve the problem. Okay, that too, specifically slider crank mechanism problem with the use of relative velocity methods. Okay, that's all for now, students, for this video. We will complete this video with this. So in the next class, I may take any other mechanism and solve using the relative velocity method. Okay, so that's all for now. Wait for the next video. Okay, whenever you have a doubt, you just go back in the video and you can clarify your doubts. Okay, so thank you very much.